your WAPT.com Storm Shield 16 weather.
Well, Lee moved through here yesterday, soaking us across the region. You can see the bulk of the heavy rains now out of the area here. We're still seeing a couple of isolated showers behind Lee, but for the most part, the worst is over. Check out some of these rainfall totals across the region at the International Airport at Jackson, picking up over 11 inches of rain, and you see those totals more than 8 inches in Raleigh. So definitely some flooding concerns across the area. So we do have those flood warnings in place here across the viewing area, as well as flash flood watch for our eastern counties that are still seeing a little bit of that rainfall moving through as Lee pushes through Alabama. Here on the satellite, you can see all of the cloud cover associated with Lee as he continues to work his way through Alabama. And we have had a cold front that is working its way through, and that's given Lee the kick that he needed to get on out of here. And behind it, notice those clear skies, and that's what's going to start to move in here as we get into Tuesday. But it's kind of going to be on the slow side, and we're really going to see a taste of fall as we get into this upcoming week. So some very big changes ahead here, as we've been seeing that hot summer pattern for so long. That all changes for Tuesday. We see Lee's leftovers continuing to work their way through Alabama. I am expecting mostly cloudy skies for the day tomorrow, especially in our eastern counties, as it will be a little bit slower to clear out. Across the west, though, like in places like Vicksburg, you will see a few more peaks of sunshine, but still on the cloudy side for Tuesday. As we get into Wednesday, we are going to see high pressure building in, and we will start to see some more sunshine, but it is still going to be on the cool side as we go through the next couple of days. Quick look at the tropics. We do have Hurricane Katia out in the Atlantic. She was just upgraded to a major hurricane, so a Category 3. But the way her track looks right now, it looks as though she is going to continue to make her way towards the East Coast before moving back out to sea. So something that we will continue to keep an eye on, but of course, no threat here in Mississippi. So for tonight, we will see a couple of lingering showers across the eastern counties. Most places are going to stay dry, though, but look at this. We are dropping down to 53 degrees tonight, so you can definitely turn off the air conditioner and keep it off for the next couple of days. Tomorrow, we'll just see sun and clouds, and it is still going to be on the breezy side, but highs are only going to be in the middle 70s. That'll be the case as we get into Wednesday as well. We'll keep those highs in the 70s. As we get into Thursday and Friday, we will gradually see those temperatures climbing back up into the lower 80s with plenty of sunshine.